All right, so the contents of the bench have changed. I've got the cold well machine up here with the thermometer. Have the Frigidaire cold control that we're going to check and see when it switches on and off. These are amazingly well made. It doesn't even have pivot points. That's a leaf spring that flexes when it when the movable arm goes up and down from temperature changes. So there's no pivot points to wear and alter the calibration. And the toggle part that makes it gives it snap action in here is also done with a leaf spring and not a pivot. Right in there where that little button is, that part flexes. So the only wear point is where those springs are attached and keeping everything under tension. So just not designed to wear out. It's really just designed to keep on going. I haven't had to take this out, so I'm not sure how large the contacts are under there, but I would assume that would be the only thing that would ever go out, assuming the bellows doesn't get punctured. So I cleaned this in evaporust, and it put a yellow powdery coating on it. I've tried several different methods to get that off, and it doesn't want to come off. So this is hidden by the cover. Once this cover's cleaned up, it'll look fine. It's disappointing, but trying to find original parts like this and one that's still good, we just have to take what we can get. The cold well machine is very simple. It's an old condensing unit from an Ideal Slider Coke cooler. And this is a double wall copper pipe, and that's the evaporator. The refrigerant boils in between the two walls of the pipe. And there's an agitator in here, a little pump that helps to minimize a gradient, temperature gradient. So there's flowing cold fluid that goes around the sensor of the thermostat and the sensor of the thermometer. And hopefully that will help the thermometer indicate a representative temperature close to what the thermostat is sensing. And the only downside of this is that it's not automated. At this point, I'm planning to do something like that, but at this point, it's manual, and the compressor is way oversized, so the temperature drop is very quick, and it's too quick to catch the exact point where the thermostat switches. So I have to run it a few moments at a time, work the temperature down once it's getting close to cutout, but then the temperature rise is gradual, so that side of it works pretty good. But for something that was almost free, it works pretty darn good. So the sensor for the thermometer is only active at one point where the thermistor is located, and this capillary bulb is active across its whole length. So that does introduce error, especially if I have a gradient along the temperature well. So I like to put the thermistor point kind of in the center and tape these together so that they'll try to pick up the same temperature. Now this assembly will go down into the well on the machine over here. All right, I've got the thermometer turned on. I don't know how visible this is going to be on the camera when it trips. I guess you can see some motion there. And power up the cold well compressor. Now I'm just going to let it run down at its speed it normally runs this time, and then to get some idea of where it's going to trip at, and then after that I'll go slower to try and figure out the exact point. These water bath machines typically have a minimum differential between the cut-in and cut-out because you got tremendous thermal mass in the water. And the cycles are hours long anyway, so they minimize the differential between cut in and cut out. This screw is what does that on this thermostat, and it was pretty much bottomed out to minimize that. So I'm expecting or thinking this probably is already set up for a water bath machine, but we're going to find out. While that's cooling down, I'm going to show the condenser. I got it cleaned up and painted. Here's the repair down there where the valve was cut off. I know it's up too close to the camera, but I want to move the camera because I'm doing the temperature test. So once the condensing unit base paint's dried, I'll be able to start putting these parts back together. I've also cleaned up and painted the compressor, and it's paint's drying right now. It should trip off any moment if it's truly set for a water bath. My concern is that the rate of change is way too fast for this thermostat to respond. But again, this is just an initial test to see where it trips. One thing I notice on this control, when these were calibrated at the factory, they put a scribe line right there. And normally that this movable part is part of the mechanism. When it should be on that scribe line, if I'm not mistaken, with this in the mid position, and it won't go down and reach the scribe line. And you know, warmer is down, so it's obviously much colder than where the scribe line is. And it may be so badly out of calibration like that that it can't trip off no matter what, no matter how cold it gets. Well, we're below 0 Fahrenheit now. That's 18 below Celsius. So obviously it should have tripped off long ago, but I'm just curious how cold it's going to take to trip it off. Thinking what may happen with this up above that line, the spring may not have any pressure at all on it, and so therefore there's no way for it to go down anymore. Well, there's definitely something wrong with the control. Oh, there it went, right there. I started to talk trash about it. So 10 below 0 Fahrenheit, or 23 below 0°C. Clearly that's not valid for a water bath cooler. I'm gonna turn off the compressor, let the temperature start climbing. So, the way this calibration is adjusted is similar to the GE thermostats. You take the knob off completely, and that allows you to rotate the stem many turns in either direction. Because the stop is that little tab and this peg up here. So what I'm going to do first, I'm just going to run it down to that line. Where the score mark and the tab are lined up. And we shall see. But unfortunately for you guys, I'm out of time for today. Got some other obligations. And this will take probably another 20 minutes to warm back up and cycle off, or at least warm up to 32 around our set point where I can work with it. And I'm going to pick back up tomorrow. Control does function, but badly out of calibration. Gonna try to get it dialed in and have this part ready to go back on the system. Get a better look at that motor. I put a little bit of clear coat over the nameplate. Fan blade painted in silver so that it'll have a good high contrast. Hopefully won't chew anyone's fingers up. All ready to go there. Here's a better view of the condenser. This is natural, it's a tinned steel coil. All I did is clean the paint off of it. And then of course I repainted the receiver. So that's ready to go back on there. Well, that's it for today. Hope y'all are enjoying seeing this get fixed up, and thanks for watching.